This is what Super Typhoon Haiyan looked like from the International Space Station. The storm was so massive that it was about the only thing astronauts could see out the window. This photo is just one of many taken by American astronaut Karen Nyberg. She was on the ISS for 5.5 months, and she joins us now from Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. Thank you for being able to join us. I mean, what was it like taking a photograph like that and realizing the impact that it might have on Earth as you looked out the window?
It definitely makes you think, because it is so beautiful when you look out the window, and I couldn't even get it in one picture, the entire storm. I used a 50mm lens to get as much as I could, but just knowing the devastation underneath that beautiful clouds and that beautiful storm is pretty sad.
Yeah, and we're still hearing those awful stories coming from the Philippines. But you've also taken some other photographs that have been just as beautiful and not caused such devastating impact, like sunrises, for example.
Yes, I love taking pictures, and in fact, I was enjoying it more and more as the mission went on, and that's probably the thing one of the things I'll miss the most from being there. And it was a great geography lesson too for me to get the pictures from all over the world.
Yeah, I wonder if you see the world in the same way before you went up first as an astronaut. I know this obviously wasn't your first trip.
You actually do see it a little different, and you feel a little bit closer to everybody. In a strange way, you just feel closer, and I wish everybody could experience that.
Well, some people might start experiencing it rather soon, civilians as it were, but let me ask you, of course, you know, it's all about space exploration and experiments, and can you give us a sense of what kind of experiments you were working on while you were up there?
Well, there's quite a few going on at one time, and a lot of them we're very intimately involved with, experiments that are being done on us as humans, looking at our eyesight and how that changes, and looking at our bone density and how that changes by the effects of microgravity. Plus, we also did a lot of experiments on fluids and combustion, and just a lot of these experiments are for developing systems to travel further into outer space. And a lot of them really will benefit what we're doing on Earth.
Specifically about the vision problems, some astronauts experience problems with their long-term vision after returning to Earth. Is that something, may I ask, that has happened to you? And do you know what's causing it?
Well, for me, I had some vision changes during my stay on space station, but it's coming back to normal again, and I think that's happened frequently with other astronauts. I have not experienced the long-term vision changes, but we have done all the studies, quite intensive studies on me and my crewmates when we were on board, and I haven't heard if they've had any of those issues, but I did have a short-term change in my vision on board.
But it is returning. A final question to you. You know, that's obviously one challenge that astronauts have been facing, being back on Earth. What have you noticed being back on Earth since you've come back from the International Space Station?
I've noticed that it seems like I never left in a lot of ways. It's very interesting. Time has gone. It's almost a time warp sometimes. You get back to your home and back to work, and it's almost like you never left. And I think I'll need to go back and look at my pictures pretty soon and just kind of reminisce.
Yeah, it's almost like being on a vacation and being back to work a few days later.
Exactly.
Karen Nyberg, thank you so much for joining us, and appreciate the photos that you've also been sharing with the entire world from space. Take care.
Thank you. Thank you very much.